Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today the Android March 2020 update came out along with a feature drop for the Google Pixel devices. Now, this is out to all supported Google Pixel devices, starting with the Google Pixel 2, 2 XL, and going all the way to the 4 and 4 XL. It's also available usually for the essential phones the same day, and then Samsung and other manufacturers will roll it out to their own devices soon. Now, there's a feature drop that goes along with this, so I'm going to go over all the new features and then go over all of the updates along with the security bulletins and things like that. Now, I had to sideload this, so this was about 1.5 to 2 gigabytes because it wasn't showing up, but you'll see it says up to date, version 10, March 5th, 2020. So this is completely up to date, even though it's not March 5th yet. That's how they do it. And here is the build number. You'll see on my Pixel 4 XL, it's QQ2A. .200305.003. And in this particular update is a huge amount of security updates, fixes, improvements, all sorts of things. So let's start with the first one. And the first one has to do with something they actually showed in the Android 11 preview. And that is if you're playing a song here. So let me start this song. If I'm playing this song, there's now a new gesture on the Pixel 4 and 4 XL to pause the song. Now it doesn't seem to work completely for me. It worked on Android 11, but it's not working here, and you do have to turn it on in gestures. So you'll see as I bring my hand close, it's not turning the song off. But if I go into the features and gestures here, you'll see that I have gestures available to pause music. And so if I go into this, it's turned on, and you just bring your hand close by tapping to resume it or pause it. And again, like I said, it's not really working properly, but it is something that's there. So I'm not sure why that's not working, but it's not at this time. Now, the next thing they've updated is car crash detection. It rolls out for the Pixel 4 in Australia and the UK. It's also in the United States. So if you go into the personal safety app here, you'll see that you can turn on car crash detection. So it will turn it on. You can say try a demo, and it says, see and hear what happens when your phone detects a car crash. Make sure your volume is up. So you'll see we'll turn it up a little bit. We'll hit start. And it says detected, and then you can hit I'm okay, or 911, or no crash, minor crash. So it's kind of neat. It's a nice safety feature, and if you want to use it, it's there. So that's nice that they've added it. Now, if you use Google Duo, there's some new effects that they've added for AR or augmented reality. So let's go into Duo. And if we go into Duo here, you'll see we'll go here, and now we have some effects, and I can have a little cat sitting on my head. We've got Scooby-Doo, you've got a little phone here. So there's some new effects here as well, all sorts of things that you can add. And it tracks your face really well. They're kind of goofy, but they work pretty well, and they're there if you want to use them. So those have been added. Now, they've also updated the forward-facing camera on the Pixel 4 and 4 XL. And what they've done is added depth to it. So apparently it has better depth. If I take a selfie here, you'll see it takes a second to process, and now there's some depth in the background. So they've improved this, made it a lot better, and it should be working even better than it was before. Now, if you're on a Pixel 2 and 2 XL, there's good news. You get live captions. So if you're using video and watching video, you can enable live captioning. So that's a new feature. And then they've added new emoji from the Unicode 12.1 release. So that means if we go into messages, you'll see I have a few here, but you have a pilot, a fireman, an astronaut, and then you have all sorts of different genders and things. There's 169 new emoji. So they've added that. They've added jobs and all sorts of things. So those are added. I'll link Unicode in the description if you want to check them all out. But there are a ton of new emoji that's brought them up to speed. There will be more new emoji the second half of the year, but this brings them up to the first half to match up with Unicode 12.1. Now, if you're using Google Pay and the wallet, you can enable a quick press of the home button to bring up your card. So if you press and hold, you'll have access to your cards, your credit cards, and any other card you add. So maybe you want to add a card such as Starbucks, or maybe you want to even add a pass for, say, a flight that you're taking. You can actually take a picture of it and add it to the wallet now as well. So you have all of these different options, and you just press and hold the power button. You do have to enable that as well, though. Now, a lot of people love dark mode. So if we go into our settings, go to display and styles, and go to dark theme, We'll tap on that and we can turn it on until sunrise now or turn it off until sunset. We have scheduling options now. And this was something we saw with the Android 11 preview as well, but they've brought it here to Android 10 with the latest Pixel update. And then there's also new automation rules for Wi-Fi networks. And this allows you to basically set a rule. So we'll go back here. We'll go to rules. And what we can do is add a rule, and then we can automatically have it change to say, do not disturb, or set the phone to silent based off the Wi-Fi network that you're connecting to. So that's a feature they've added. So you can just add a network, say set to vibrate, set to ring, or whatever, based off not only location, but based off your Wi-Fi network. Now there's a feature that hasn't fully rolled out yet for the Pixel feature drop. And that is not only a long press for an icon, but a firm press. So if you firm press, sort of like 3D touch on iOS, you've got new task, but if I firm press, it really doesn't do anything different. You can long press and get the same result. So there's supposedly something else coming out that's going to be a firm press. And finally, for the feature drop, the Pixel 4 and 4 XL screens that are set to use adaptive brightness. And I'm currently on manual because I don't want it to go brighter when I'm under these bright lights for this video. But under manual, if you have this on automatic instead, what it will do is actually go super bright now if you're outside in direct sunlight. So it should make the screen even easier to see. So that'll be really nice for some of those that were experiencing kind of a dim screen on the 4 and 4XL. Now that's it for the feature drop, but there are a ton of fixes and improvements as well. So let's go over those. Now, as far as the fixes and improvements, I'll mention all of them, but if they're specific to a device, I'll say the device specifically. Otherwise, it pertains to all the devices that are supported by this update. So the first one is in apps. There's a fix for certain app overlay elements stuck on the home screen. So if you had overlays not showing properly, that should be fixed. Now in audio, you can now disable now playing for music when you're playing it on a cast device. So maybe you're playing music on a device you're casting to, it will now have the ability to disable now playing if you want to do that. They've also fixed static noise during audio capture. So maybe you're using your phone to record audio in a classroom. If there was static, that should now be fixed. And specific to the Pixel 4, not the 4 XL, there's improvements to the bottom speaker driver. So if you have a 4 and the bottom speaker wasn't working well, it should be better. Now for all devices, again, there's improvements for Bluetooth connectivity with specific or certain fitness tracking devices. So if you're having issues maybe with a Fitbit or something like that, it should be better. There's also quite a few improvements to cameras on not just the Pixel 4 and 4XL, but other devices as well. The first one is improvements to autofocus in the camera. So if you're using the camera on your phone on any Pixel device, the autofocus should be improved if it supports this update. Then on the Pixel 4 and 4XL, there's a fix for the camera crashing when switching to video mode. So if you're switching from, say, camera to video, it should fix that. There's also a fix for camera's auto white balance in certain scenarios. So that's specific to the Pixel 4 and 4XL again. And if it wasn't auto white balancing properly, it should be improved. Now, when it comes to connectivity using USB specifically on the Pixel 4 and 4XL, it fixes an issue with unrecognized USB accessories. So those should be fixed. And then they've improved face unlock on the Pixel 4 and 4XL as well. And it's only issues where it gets stuck. So the first one is they fixed an issue where it gets stuck on the lock screen after the device is unlocked with a face. So maybe it unlocks and it's stuck on the lock screen. Now it will go to the home screen properly. And they've also fixed an issue for incorrect text translation in settings. So maybe you have face unlock settings turned on, the text might not have shown the proper translation in those settings. That should be improved as well. Now, as far as motion sense on the Pixel 4 and 4XL, they've improved visual feedback for motion sense gestures. So again, if I go in, I'll just play this here. And with this song playing, if I move my hand, it should go to the next song. Now, my motion gestures are not working. The alarm worked fine this morning when I swiped my hand in front of it. But for some reason, the motion gestures are not working properly on this device. So hopefully they fix that as well or improves in the future. Now, there are a lot of fixes to the system that you can't see behind the scenes, to kernel updates and things like that. But I'll talk more about that with the security updates. But there's actual fixes to the system kernel as well. So there's three fixes for that. They're basically specific for each Pixel device. So there's fixes for the 2 and 2XL, 3A, 3AXL, 3XL, 3, 4, 4XL. Now there's also improvements to the overall system user interface. So switching with gesture navigation, so the animation, switching between things, they've actually improved the animation. And then they've also clarified the dark theme helper text in settings. So they've changed it in settings where we go to display, and again, to the dark theme. There's different text here, so it's just a little bit more clear. So all these little tweaks, they're really fixing a lot of things. Now they've also fixed with telephony undismissible location access notifications after an emergency call. So specifically, you'd have to place an emergency call with your dialer, and it's fixed issues with that. They've also fixed a few video issues for all of the devices. This one in particular, though, is for the Pixel 3 XL, 3, 3A, 3A XL. When you're doing video playback in certain apps when using picture-in-picture mode. So not on this device, but if you have a Pixel 3, 3A, those devices, it should be fixed in. They've also improved 4K video playback on all of the devices. They've also fixed corrupted video playback in certain apps after locking the screen. And then they've also fixed Wi-Fi. So lost Wi-Fi network configurations. I actually had that happen on my Pixel 4 XL. I think in the last version, the Wi-Fi connection just disappeared. Now it's fixed. And those are all of the different fixes and improvements with this update. So lots of different things. And then finally, there are a ton of security patches as well. And I'll just run down through these pretty quickly. Now, as far as the framework, there are 4 different security patches. There's 7 patches to the media framework, 24 to system, 1 to the Google Play system updates, 28 kernel components have been patched security-wise, FPC components, there's 6 of those, there's 1 MediaTek component, 12 Qualcomm components, and then 42 Qualcomm closed source security components. All of those patches are in the updates on this current March 2020 security update. So that is a ton of things patched. In fact, it's one of the most, or if not the most, feature-packed update I've seen since maybe Android 10 was released. So lots of things in there. Now, battery overall, there's no mention of changes to that. And this device usually does pretty well. I can get through a day on battery, and you'll see my battery here. Let me get into the usage there. My battery here, I haven't used it a ton today. I've been busy recording other videos. And then speed and performance, I've never had an issue on the Pixel 4 or 4XL. I find I only have to reboot it rarely. And in fact, this has not been rebooted since I did the Android 11 update and then flashed it back to the Pixel security updates. So that was last week or so when I did that. So it's been on, I haven't rebooted it, and it's been doing really well. So in general, it's working well. I'm looking forward to more updates like this, and all of those features are great to see added to the Pixel lineup. So let me know if you've had that already added. I actually had to sideload the update, like I said, but if you have the Pixel feature drop, let me know. All of those things should be there, except maybe a couple that the firm press, for example. There's just nothing really there. Other than that, it should be updated. Now, if you found anything else new, let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description, as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.